Successful organizations recognize that analytic models are essential corporate assets that produce and deliver answers to production systems for improved customer relationships, improved operations, increased revenues, and reduced risks. So, they seek to create the best models possible. However, few fully manage all the complexities of the complete analytical model life cycle. It's such a multifaceted task. Therefore, it is important to develop an iterative analytics life cycle to guide organizations step by step through the process of going from data to decision. In order to provide a framework to organize the work needed by an organization and deliver clear insights from big data, it's useful to think of it as a cycle with different stages. The CRISPDM methodology, that stands for Cross-Industry Standard Process for Data Mining, is a cycle that describes commonly used approaches that data mining experts use to tackle problems in traditional business intelligence data mining. It is still being used in traditional business intelligence data mining teams. The CRISPDM life cycle consists of the following stages. First, business understanding. This initial phase focuses on understanding the project objectives and requirements from a business perspective, and then converting this knowledge into a data mining problem definition. Second, data understanding. The data understanding phase starts with an initial data collection and proceeds with activities in order to get familiar with the data, to identify data quality problems, to discover first insights into the data, or to detect interesting subsets to form hypotheses for hidden information. Third, data preparation. The data preparation phase covers all activities to construct the final dataset, the data that will be fed into the modeling tools from the initial raw data. Data preparation tasks are likely to be performed multiple times and not in any prescribed order. Tasks include table, record, and attribute selection, as well as transformation and cleaning of data for modeling tools. Fourth, modeling. In this phase, various modeling techniques are selected and applied, and their parameters are calibrated to optimal values. Typically, there are several techniques for the same data mining problem type. Fifth, evaluation. At this stage in the project, you have built a model that appears to have high quality from a data analysis perspective. Before proceeding to final deployment of the model, it is important to evaluate the model thoroughly and review the steps executed to construct the model to be certain it properly achieves the business objectives. A key objective is to determine if there is some important business issue that has not been sufficiently considered. At the end of this phase, a decision on the use of the data mining results should be reached. And finally, sixth, deployment. Creation of the model is generally not the end of the project. Even if the purpose of the model is to increase knowledge of the data, the knowledge gained will need to be organized and presented in a way that is useful to the customer. Depending on the requirements, the deployment phase can be as simple as generating a report or as complex as implementing a repeatable data scoring or data mining process. In many cases, it will be the customer, not the data analyst, who will carry out the deployment steps. Even if the analyst deploys the model, it is important for the customer to understand upfront the actions which will need to be carried out in order to actually make use of the created models. SEMA is another methodology developed by SAS for data mining modeling. It stands for Sample, Explore, Modify, Model, and Assess. Here is a brief description of its stages. Sample. The process starts with data sampling. For instance, selecting the dataset for modeling. The dataset should be large enough to contain sufficient information to retrieve, yet small enough to be used efficiently. This phase also deals with data partitioning. Explore. This phase covers the understanding of the data by discovering anticipated and unanticipated relationships between the variables, and also abnormalities, with the help of data visualization. Modify. The modify phase contains methods to select, create and transform variables in preparation for data modeling. Model. In the model phase, the focus is on applying various modeling and data mining techniques on the prepared variables in order to create models that possibly provide the desired outcome. Assess. The evaluation of the modeling results shows the reliability and usefulness of the created models. The main difference between CRISM, DM and SEMA is that SEMA focuses on the modeling aspect, whereas CRISP-DM gives more importance to stages of the cycle prior to modeling, such as understanding the business problem to be solved, understanding and pre-processing the data to be used as input, for example, machine learning algorithms.